Well, hello everyone, welcome back to a new stream and new episode of World Super League Career Mode. Today we carry on in January. So, Man City game at home, then a trip to Lisbon to take on Sporting before we conclude our League Cup semi-final away trip to White Hart Lane ahead. We drew a home game against Spurs 0-0 on the first leg, but no away goals count, so you know. We can't just draw one all and go through. We have to beat Spurs fair and square there. And then we'll conclude deadline day. So we might have an FA Cup game to come on one of these Saturdays. I'm not 100% sure. I might end up falling that one. And the Spurs game will most likely get rearranged. But yeah, for sure we'll be facing them in this episode. But first up is Man City. We did manage to beat 1-0 at the Etihad earlier on the season. As you can see though, we do have to make changes. We have players who are really tired. Like Tavuri drops out for Ivan, who then swaps with Lilovic. Hernandez is going to make way for Timofeo. And we'll put Robinson, who can play right back, and has 5-star weak foot at left back. So, you know, in theory, he could then play left back as well. Who to put on the bench though? Right, we'll go with Ronaldo. We are fucking stacked of strikers on the bench right now, to be fair. So I need another midfielder up. We're up for money. What am I on about? I've got Ake on the bench. I don't know why I didn't stick him on, so I might as well put Timofeyo off, Ake there, and Robinson there. Timofeyev might well get on for Christensen at some point. Don't want to rest too many, because we do have a week's gap after this game, so we can afford to leave it a bit later for subs. So we drew the last league game against Manchester United, funnily enough, and Spurs won, so they have closed the gap to within 2 points. Our goal difference is still so much better, so if we get another draw and they get a win, we'll still be top. But of course, we're on a return to winning ways today, and look at that. Jesus Christ. Off the bar there, and still at the target for Kevin, who does travel back against his old club. I think he scored against them, De Bruyne, in that 1-0 win. Sure, it was like a goal from a former City player, and he's the only one I can think of. So Ivan's going to hold this up. Bournemouth are going to go with this team. Sides across the man. Chance by Paul Pogba. He's been the turn cloak that is Paul Pogba. City signed him off United. Lovely little heel inside. Across the man. Right on. Neymar to Lukaku. Oh, should have been a good start. Should have put that in really wrong. But we should have noticed straight away while threat. So here's Angelino, Pogba. Paul, where are you going, lads? Let's continue to force him back. Let's spread it out to Alessandro Florenzi, who finds it Sane. His pass is intercepted. Ake, De Bruyne, to Lilovic. Alan Lilovic.
They've won the away game against this club they're facing today.
It's caught in between players there, really. It didn't find De Bruyne, didn't find Lukaku, didn't he?
The losing side will have a point to prove because
no one.
They really didn't turn off in that first game.
Kroos, well, the San Kroos I forgot for such a good deal.
Excellent.
I remember looking at it and was like, I couldn't believe how cheap he went for. It was only about 40 mil, wasn't it? Good play between Rom and Neymar. There's a chance
on the
outside here for
situation.
Ivan. Oh my god, come on. Right, we did win a free kick. I was going to say, I got clipped then, just as I'm about to cross it in for Neymar. That. Instead, Kevin now will get the opportunity. In fact, should I go for this? I think I might. He's against his old club. It's a tight angle, but it's written in the stars for Kevin. Oh, he hit the post. Fuck's sake. Almost there. It would have been a hammer blow for City. We signed him off then this summer. Good chance by Klopp normally.
Fernando.
Oh, it's unlucky. I'd read that pass to Pogba as well. Anticipate defense, still the best got it. Defense in the division. Oh, before it goes in. Brasco whips it in. He's lit up by Christensen. And to Ivan. In this company, feeds in Kevin. The weakest pass in the world, but doesn't matter. As this one.
Yeah, you would fancy
entirely get it off
as
wrong.
As they don't now take the foot off the gas.
Making a run down the side. Pretty wrong, Lukaku. Whips it in for Neymar. Have you missed that?
His stock in trade.
Oh my
he
god.
Loves the ball to attack.
That's two sick opportunities about the first 20 minutes. It should be 1-0 at least. I was aiming for the post across, and in the end. Jesus Christ, that was wayward. His heading accuracy isn't the best, but he did score one recently against Barcelona.
Rushing it here.
His old team.
From one side to the other.
Yeah, Ndone.
And that's good support as they build this attack.
Play by Ndone.
It's a passing game. And
Og
word,
cuts inside.
Well,
great touch. Oh my god, good save on him. That was a lovely little back heel from Kroos for the settle.
Corner now for Manchester City.
Corner fed short to Sané. Leroy. What's he going to do? He continues going backwards. Let's carry on forcing him. He's found a pass to Kroos, who feeds it inside to Florenzi.
Well, a damp moment.
He was on his weak foot.
On a damp day and, for him.
Yeah, showed.
It was an opportunity, but he couldn't keep his footing at all.
Robinson, what am I doing? Nothing there. It's a great ball inside. Wait, well in. Hernandez. What defender, nice. It looked a bit like a foul, to be honest. I don't know. It wasn't given, so clearly not. Lukaku, there's a ball on outside, it's Ake. We'll cut inside. Oh, he's done so well there. And another free kick. We'll try and play the short if we can. It's who Neymar and Kevin now. Bruyne!
Just right, he had a real go.
Well, you can't knock him. He was in the right place at the right time. Just couldn't provide the finishing touch.
How many players are? Fucking hell. Seems to have no one in midfield then. It was really weird. Osu, that's a good ball, that.
Get any football fan will say when the rain comes down like it's coming down.
Easy for Leno.
To the thrills, a few spills possibly.
Plays it out to Hilivic.
I always used to like it. Osu. He quite often meant you got a few more chances in the box with the
Kevin.
Bounce of the ball and what have you.
Oh, it's unlucky that run. Okay, should have been
good
on
position.
That.
They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous
Robinson
position
now. Robinson, what is the first touches about here, boys?
To try and find an opening.
Such a rapist there from Fosu Mensa, that was shite. So we had a good opportunity to break it. We might again now though. Just Kevin, he's only strong.
Tries the through pass.
Lukaku! Oh, big block.
Well, this is a corner, and they've got to defend properly against it.
First of the game, I think. De Bruyne to whip it in. Headed out on as far as Lukaku. I didn't really want him touching it, to be honest. I'd have happily seen that. Head straight back to De Bruyne. Played out here to Ake.
Could be dangerous.
He gives it to Lukaku. Onto De Bruyne. Looking inside for Neymar.
Very straightforward save for the goalkeeper.
Fucking defender was there. Carrasco. Ndone.
Fernando.
Fernando, what a ball that is. Sané. Lin Ake.
It's a corner for Manchester City.
They look the same. Ake's better though. Head short. Sané. Oh, good ball. Carrasco.
Good tackle. Lilovic.
So Lilovic plays it out to Ake here. De Bruyne. A lot of space here for Neymar. If he can do something with it. Oh, what a tackle that was. Pay rare to them. So again, wow, for a game and a half now, we failed to score, 0-0. Spurs are winning as well against Chelsea, so they will join us on
49, this could be a problem for the referee in the second half
if we
because
get this
the
draw.
Rain is still lashing down.
Get up wrong. Just fall over people.
Yannick Carrasco.
Shit game Lukaku today. And then Robinson. Love that. Big chance to break here.
Onto the attack now.
Great ball. It's Fosu Mensah. Timothy. Oh, what a save. Didn't make the most of that break though. Neymar didn't make the right run when I wanted him to. Lukaku the same. You know, fed it through one on one with five of them, it would have been goal time. Though. Didn't really want Fosu Mensah on it, the centre defensive.
Knocking the ball around.
Excellent work from Robinson to start.
Had a good look at that. It's just a throw after the tackle.
Is it back to Angelino?
Stones. Short passes.
To Pogba.
Ball.
Nice little turn.
Substitute for Manchester City.
He was looking inside. That was blocked by
Alan Halilovic. Free kick against Manchester City.
Dirty bastards, these. Five fouls already in this match. Sliding in on the players everywhere. Okay, chance here.
With some danger.
Lukaku, come on, wrong.
Challenge here.
Better than this. Big tackle. So lucky, Man City. Then, so fucking jammy, and they could get in here as well. Fuck sake. He did as well. That was so lucky. Made the block, I think. I can't even actually remember what happened now. Directly, whether it was a block or a tackle, but I just remember them getting lucky. Let's refresh it. Yeah, I made the tackle here. Great tackle on Sane, and it bounces straight off for them to go and break. Ugh, fuck's sake.
So, finally,
so come on, we're unbeaten since September.
Broken here,
lose that.
And we have a goal.
They didn't deserve this lead at all, in my opinion. About three great chances.
Moving forward,
we should have scored.
Some danger to the opposition.
Oh, it could be in here though. Rom.
Lukaku.
Good save again by Rooney.
He got a touch to that.
Geronimo. Man called Geronimo was the man.
Could be a problem. They've got to defend it well.
Hang your head. I'm going to feel caught. Milinovic.
Here comes the support.
Side to Lukaku. Fosu. Ake.
Oh,
good challenge by Stones. Just about to shoot. And Ake stayed down.
Fernando.
Seems to be stopping play. We should be okay.
Kroos.
And to carry on. But of course, we are playing with 10 men right now. And Sane's pace is killing.
Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. Well, we might get an update on that injury now from our man.
To Kroos. On again. Oh, out. Off the bar.
Here's the shot.
Ah, followed up by Kroos. Fuck, that might be it. Oh, we are taking a stumbling form recently. I think all these games are starting to catch up with us. Fosu will be into CDM. We'll bring Manny on. And it's a good team affair of game time, actually. Might as well do that. Play Munoz there and Robinson in his CDM role, which you can, of course, do a job in.
Got a firmer
grip on the game. I mean, they put men forward then. When it fell to Kroos, the player I took control of tried to close it down. A player of mine was in the way. There was a degree of bad luck. And again, that happens. See what I mean? What the fuck's that? Went for that ball then. Two players. That is exactly what happened last time. So it's funny enough, as I mentioned it, it happened again. More obviously there. But sometimes shit like this happens in FIFA and it's just so frustrating. It's like,
20 minutes now.
The player you're controlling, you can't control the movements of your players, you're not. And sometimes they do just get in the way.
He's gone and won the ball.
Oh my god, when we lose our first match, it was always bound to happen in a long time, but we might lose this mentally because we have
Neymar
committed a lot of attack.
Good defending.
Man City could well break on his ear.
Safe to play.
He loses so many teams.
Good with his feet. Well, the rain has been
very heavy. So lucky today.
Just starting to ease a bit, thank goodness.
Yeah, I was getting wet up here in the gantry, Martin, so a bit of a relief that.
We've played just as well as Man City in this match, in my opinion. Good ball over to Ake. Manny.
Foul,
oh my god. You fouling dirty little cunt. There's another one there.
Trying to find an opening.
Team affair.
Not panicking.
It's Money. Oh, it's off the bar. Followed up by Neymar. Save. Great save again by Rulli.
Not such
again
a good game
by Munoz and Al. So what an effort by Money though.
We've got 10 minutes left on
Marcos.
The clock.
Marcos. In the wrong position there. Pogba.
And the home side will play again in the Premier League.
It's Carrasco, they've got such pace across their team. Carrasco, Sane, DeMarcos.
There goes the cross.
It's proving hard to deal with right now. It's going to be our throw-in.
That's gone out for a throw-in.
Oh, lovely from you, Manny. A good game, actually. One of the few is. Okay.
That's cut out.
It's come out to Ake again.
Wide again.
Nathan. Well in. A bit of luck there. And it's the ball inside. Oh, it's a shit pass, Ake. What the fuck is that? It would have been a hard finish anyway, because it was Timofeyev and he ended up, but could have been back in the game.
Well, he's threaded the path through neatly.
Ball inside for Mane, who didn't need to take the touch, but he still did. Come on, boys. And Neymar, De Bruyne, Munoz does get a goal, come on. Just the time. Heading towards stoppage time now. You'll probably keep the ball for fucking ages now.
They want to get back for the kickoff because they have got this goal. Now they're just one down, but
come on,
the
tackling quick. No chances or less. And we might have it. His team of favour win the ball there. He's going through, he's not slow. And again, you dirty cunt. I had 3-2 then. Talk about taking one for the team, you dirty little shit, DeMarco.
It's a bad one, yellow.
Fuck off.
Yeah, no surprise there at all.
Munoz has the ball here, though. Ah, I'm going to feed it short. Timofeyev. To Mane. Oh, big block by Pogba. That could have been the chance. He had the angle. And in the end, completely undeserved, in my opinion. The stats may say different, but I don't even care what they say. No, look at that. We had 12 shots to their 5, 7 on target to their 3. We also hit the bar with one that wasn't on target. They dominated possession, but yeah, that's so tight. When it's got 3 on target, score 2. And one of their goals came straight from a tackle of mine, which rebounds off one of their players. And the other time, I'm trying to block Kroos' shot and another dickhead player gets in the way. Elsewhere though, we got a bit lucky. Chelsea drew with Spurs. Manchester City, a bit against form actually. Chelsea are in the bottom three right now. So we do still sit top. Juventus, only by a point though, and it's in this case of missed opportunities really. The game's against Man United. And Spurs. And we drew another one recently as well. Oh no, it was a game against Spurs in the Cup, to be fair. So yeah, we have dropped 5 points against the Manc clubs. Haven't beaten both earlier on the season, so could have been so much better, that league table. The important thing is that we are still a point clear.
In fourth, Borussia Dortmund
continue the training here,
but only behind on goal difference. In fifth, climbing the table are Sevilla with 34 points. In seventh,
so Maxime's closing in on a 67 rating there, which is lovely stuff.
Rising up the table are Paris Saint-Germain with 29 points.
I really do believe that he can get to 90. Some has potential to be special people you look at and you're like, oh, you've got so far to grow, like to Sean Shaw, who's 80. Aidan Alexander, by the way, is another one who has potential to be special. Locomotive on him in a short term loan, so I'm happy to see that. Because he never really plays for us. Kedenyas, bid for him. I don't really want to sell him, but I do only ever really need 2 quality keepers, so as a result of not really being in a rush to get rid of him, I've been slightly open. I'll put a bid in that is still massive. They're going to say no, but it's not in the realms of impossibility. 40 mil. You know his agent. Maybe they do just fancy having a new beast in there. I do expect him to say no, though. Real Madrid accepted that 9 million bid for Sergio Diaz, actually. Well, it could be worth going in for. Transfer off of PFAR. Did it say I was considered selling this guy, so I'm open to it. No way am I selling him for 3 mil, though. I think Payard has potential to be special, which is 85 plus, so, you know. It's a good deal for both, but I'm not selling for anything less than 8 mil. If anything, that's a bargain for CSKA, but they're a club that I don't think will have that money to throw up the deal, to be honest. Ewan Roberts is 76, by the way. I just thought to check him out because he's a former player who we let go and is now Man United. There's no way though if I'm getting Diaz. Yeah, it might depend on this that I'm paying that. I'm going off from 50, but off from a greater role. Sporadic first team player, I'll give him a squad rotation first player. Ronaldo is retiring at the end of the year, of course, so he could just be his replacement. 4 years, I don't even think so. I'm going to go with 2. So he won't be happy there, actually. He's not got the security he wants, or the cash. But it is a great squad draw, so I'm hopeful that'll do it. Pereira to stay. Is that Mateus Pereira? Ricardo Pereira looks pretty good, actually. But he's out of our price range right now. We don't really need him anyway, I suppose. I do like Klostermann. So on prize money, excellent. The FA Cup draw has been done, so now we can fully check the fixtures. I never did after the last episode. I'll check this before we even look at who we've got next. So Barcelona beat Bayern 2-0 in Germany. That's another big team that are out. Juventus knocked out Atletico. I didn't even notice that game. That's a big one as well. Spurs to get through. Arsenal to go to a replay. We'll see how they got in a second. So I'm just going to point out Premier League teams here, by the way. Porto got beat by Zenit. Porto led the way in this league for a while. And they've come crashing down to earth a bit. Really have dropped off. Inter got knocked out at home to PSV. Bit of a shock. Real Madrid got through. United through. City through. Chelsea through. PSG through. Liverpool are out though, got beat by Southampton 1-0. The exact scoreline beat us in the League Cup semi-final last week in real life. Another Premier League teams. I may have missed one or two out, but onto the replays. So Everton are out, beaten by Bilbao in what was a great game there, 3-0. Arsenal are through safely though. Elsewhere, Gladbach, Leicester, Lyon and Ajax progress. So we have Wolfsburg away. Don't mind that draw too much. It's another Championship team, but they're going great guns at the top of the league. They will probably be in Premier League next year. Them and Atletico. No other massive games, really. Real Madrid and Arsenal. So, as you can see, that guy just accepted that contract. I can't believe that. We have bids for Declan Shaw as well. They were brought back. 2.2 mil valuation. I'm not doing that. This guy has potential to be special, which is 90 plus. So, being realistic, you know, I could ask for like 25 mil or something, because one day he'll be worth 40 odd mil. But obviously, not going to say that. But maybe 6 mil I might be able to get hold of. The computer does bear in mind potential sometimes in bids, but wary locomotive don't have a great deal of cash, I imagine. It's got a few of these guys, none of them really stand out enough to sign right now. The main ones are strikers, and yeah, they're really short, so I might end up going for this guy from Real Madrid. He looks the best of like the regen strikers that are sort of knocking about, 77 rating. Still short on our other strikers. We have a number of them right now, you know, of Adams, Mulder, Ronaldo, Lukaku and Rashford. But as Ronaldo fades, I do think it could be worth getting him in. And, you know, might as well spend it. Normally I wouldn't sign him, but I have no other thing to spend the cash on. So yeah, we'll see what he's like. I might sell him in the summer again if he's not good. But I can check his potential now. Like, he can play everywhere, this guy, as well. Centre forward, calm, striker and left wing. Medium work rate, 4-star, weak foot, 3-star skill moves. That looks good, to be fair. Looks better than I thought. He has a trait, takes finesse free kicks. I didn't even know that was a thing. Mainly utilising him for his free kicks and his shot power. And I did say he can be trained a lot, to be fair. I don't think his finishing is great right now. So if we do make hay on that, he should hit 80 pretty soon. So check him out, we'll have an actual idea of what he's about now. centre forward. It doesn't say, of course, because the status is on recently arrived from Real Madrid for 9 mil, but as you can see, he wasn't playing there at all. He only played one game. I'm getting him in that wage, I'm quite happy, to be honest. Clearly I was looking up a guy, because this guy's finishing is 83, but head and accuracy can be improved a lot. Sokana's passing, long passing in particular. If he's playing centre forward, he'll be a bit deeper. I need that stamina improving now. 41, that's like terrible. He'll be dead by about 60 minutes into the game. Yeah, another bit. To be fair, I was complaining about lack of bids, but we've got loads this window. They said no to Payard and no to Cardenas. The Payard one's a bit gun. That one I thought was realistic. Bid for Hernandez, he's going nowhere unless it's for like monster money, so that's for 80 mil. PSG probably have that though, to be fair. So Danny Mulder's asking for a game coming up. It's a league game though, so he's not going to get much of a look in. We need to make a move. Failed to win our last two league games, so we've got the Spurs game coming up. I'll play him against them, but I will play more first team against Spurs and play a weaker team against Wolfsburg if needs be. But yeah, two games in a row, he can get game time then. I don't really understand why he's moaning. Elsewhere, I think, get in. Yes, come on. Spurs lost their game in hand. I say the game in hand, but man, we've got a game in hand now. Spurs lost their match then. We're a point ahead still for goal. With a 9 better goal difference. And I'm going to assume it was Dortmund who beat them, because they've jumped up to third. No, it's PSG. Get in. That's a bit of a shock, because I think they were like bottom or something. But Spurs, to be fair, on in the best form recently themselves. I mean, they've got 4 points from three now, so they really didn't take advantage of our stumble. So the first team's fine. I did say generally I'm going to be playing Martin a lot in the first team because Klosterman has had plenty of games this season. He had this long-term injury, of course, Martin, that he recently returned from. And if anything, that'll improve us for the Spurs because Klosterman can start right back there. It's just 7 better rating. So I seriously, what the hell? I don't know where we, oh, this is the one where you run down in it. I thought that was the one where I was passed to a player then for a second. But yeah, trying to recall what the score was when I beat Sporting Lisbon. It just came to me. We actually simmed the game against these. We only simmed 2 games all season in the league. We beat these, I think, and drew against Inter Milan. So 3-1 win is how the computer gets on against them. Let's see how we fare. Now, Alan, the away team. It should be tougher, of course, the away game. The record against Portuguese teams can be a bit suspect. So we'll see. Palinha. Alvis. Should really have checked how they're going league. I think they're doing okay. They're looking at the table. And I tell you what, this is a sick one by this guy. Mr. William Carvalho. Big tackle though on Harmar. Yeah, they had a surprisingly good first team sport in Lisbon. Both William Carvalho and Harmar were 88 rated. That style up. 20 minutes or so, they want to start. Kaku, tackled by Naldo. I was hoping we'd win it. Corner out last, just to throw in now. Someone make a run then, you fucking lazy cunt. Hide, oh, you bell end. Hiding behind each other. And gets interception now. They also play it out. Sometimes throwing just don't give you the option.
He's been in tremendous form recently. Quick into the tackle. Result is
going to
be a throw.
Seriously, on occasion, I would rather they have a throw-in because at least you have a chance to intercept yourself then. There are some situations where you can do it. Neymar, good ball in. Almost, it could have been. Could have been alerted a bit more. Borthwick Jackson, the relay player, I think. Flying his trade for Sport.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Chase Pereira, just Tim Naldo. I mean, that's the Naldo. He'd be like 48 years old by this point, isn't he? Inside to Lukaku, goes for it. It's saved by Rui Patricio himself, must be getting
it'll be a throw.
Cleared in the end by Sport, and it will be off for Halilovic. Neymar, good ball. Ferran, cleared by Tobias.
That has cost them, but only a corner could have been worse.
Ball inside. Fosu. Straight to Patricio.
And he's hung on to the ball.
Cleared away, headed on by Spalvis to Benikofobe. It's fucking our former player. How the hell he's starting in a Premier League team?
Free kick here.
By this point, I have no idea.
Kristen.
Said that, I do think he had potential. My mate also has a bomb with Grimmo, and he played really well for him. So.
Kevin De Bruyne.
Well done, Benik. I'm quite happy to see him doing well. He didn't doing score well against us. That's a lovely play, by the way, to unleash Sam Martin. He's dragged back, scored.
That's great defending there, stopping the that attack.
Cleared. And, Spalvis.
Onto the attack now.
And
a timely challenge.
Beast.
Well, the players haven't put the ball out. They're playing on, but the referee
said no. Oh, fuck off.
No.
Just play on, you bitches.
Player, and he stopped the game.
Give a shit, he's injured.
The player has gone off.
So that's just killed my move then. The I had players forward, but... I'm sure it was like 5-on-6 then or something, which I would back myself to create something from. Now I have to build from the back again.
Well, I think, Alan, the home team need a win. A couple of draws in their last two games.
Tielemans, could be a chance here.
And I think they do need that win just to give them a bit of confidence.
But we've forced Lukaku very wide, but he's done well to keep it in play. Romelu. De Bruyne, on a turn, surely. Yes, Kevin, get in. We need a win. Here today after the last two games, and we needed a goal as well. We failed to score on our last two. No, I say that we got beat by City 2-1 in the last. Generally our finishing has been a bit wasteful in recent games. The first year 1-1 this time, we do bury. So well done, Kev.
And that will be handball.
Handball for that lad that we've just recently scouted, actually Cipitelli. Christensen, side to Fosu.
Into the attacking Neymar. Third.
Gets it back. Neymar.
Played it well.
Hernandez.
Quick header. Found
Milovic. The teammate. Got on that, Alan. Martin.
Good defending.
Mateus.
Well, this
attack.
Very two
Cipitelli. I'm tracking with Hernandez. Well, then, Lucas.
Good play.
He keeps it.
Lost the ball.
Really expect that action.
The opposition could get at them.
Neymar.
Read the play well to intercept.
Ball to Kev. We feed him in now. Neymar. Romelu.
First touch was poor.
Fuck's sake.
Well, this is what happens when you lose the ball. Opposition really coming at them.
That's a spread and ball that. Romelu.
Danger.
Still we come back though. Kevin De Bruyne is just.
Well, they're in a good position here.
Skinning the moles.
Away. Defending there.
Oh, we got a back of Fosu.
Nicely worked until that point.
Just
and it broke down.
Into danger.
Now
oh,
they've got to try and regain
he's
possession.
Well done, Hernandez.
Alan
rocks it on this game. Alan Halilovic did not
good
work
way to nick the ball back. Quick thinking.
Fobe.
More news on
wanted
the
to feed
injury,
Chris to
Jeff Shreves is the man in possession of the information.
Word from the benches that he's actually twisted his knee. That's why he's trying it out. But at the moment, he's carrying on.
Is it on?
Well,
he'll have it back.
Thank
as well.
You for that update.
Boris. Romelu, why didn't he make the run then?
Challenge.
He's actually been poor relatively. Recently, wrong. Maybe the last four or five games.
Now they've
yeah,
got the
performance wise,
push forward from this
just
deepish
not
position.
Been good enough from him.
3 minutes
again,
to
he's
be added on. In quickly. Cavalier.
Fobe. Benik. No, not him. Oh my god.
That was the opening that they've been working so hard to get. To get
Jesus
back
Christ.
On
the player had a deemed surplus in the first season. If he'd have scored against me, I'd really know. But it is half time and it's still 1-0. Not the most convincing of performances, but it was enough. We have been a better team, as you can see. Four shots today, one. Four on target today, none. Tight possession. We've had one corner today, zero. And really, all the stats are quite tight, actually, except for the shot. And, of course, the scoreline, which is still 1-0.
So here we go with the second half.
Get another goal, I think that's it. I cannot see them scoring against me twice. So, we're trying to get this early on.
Neymar.
They their way Cavalier's a beast. Everywhere this guy.
Then just lost the concentration.
I've still got four shots on target, but it wouldn't
work hard to try and get it back. Referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle.
Fogo. He does have pace. He's quite direct as well. He's just running through. Benik Afogo. Fucking do this to me, Benik. Terrible header that by Hal Pereira. Play this off. Vincently, the course of throw. Instead, can we pressure this? Get on that run. Yeah, it's done. Well in. Neymar looks for Lukaku. We should run the header. For Kevin. Just couldn't make it work. It was bouncing about in the air too long.
And in he goes with the tackle.
Time to get them back.
Probing away.
Matthias.
Find room for a shot, maybe.
Well, one some more.
That's great defending there. Stopping that attack.
Oh, come on. I didn't want Halilovic to take that then. Giocatelli. Norfolk Jackson.
Sam.
Oh my god. I thought that had just gone straight through Leno for a second there. I'd have been raging at Ben Leno because it wasn't the best of shots. Good play out by Hernandez there.
Neymar here. Dwell on the ball for very long
here. Feed it away. Norfolk Jackson picks it up again. Finds Matthias.
Could be dangerous.
Yeah, still going through. Yeah, I don't really know where that was, he just hoofed it. Tielemans, I thought, was blatant.
And it's quick into the tackle.
Thank God Al Shirani. I don't know what he was doing. But that would have been there throw had he not. Neymar. Halilovic. To Neymar.
Good forward play from
looking
them.
For Lukaku, he's going to probably find it. Got it wrong. So I'll make subs in a sec. We have a Spurs game coming up pretty soon. And that is a bigger
he's
one than this. Arguably. Hernandez.
Christensen.
Boris. This is Yuri. Don't know why there wasn't much pace in this. It's made it difficult for Yuri. He's giving it away here. For fuck's sake, Boris.
We'll
fault.
See who comes on. He's got his shot off
now. Manu. Not playing as well this episode as I've done in recent ones, I feel. So I do need to work my game. What do you mean yours on? We're bringing Shea on. He's struggling for games recently, and it'll find it even harder with the guy arriving. So we take Rom off, who's really been poor this match. Kevin will be the goal hunter. And it might work now, because we'll find it too. Need Adams to start making runs. And there he goes, Shea. If we can get past this guy, he will be in. Went the long way round, he still beats it with his outrageous pace. And a triple tap of doom. Ronaldo was on it.
It was easy to cope with.
It was a good job from Sporting's perspective. That was heading straight for him. Now Giraldez with the ball. Terrible pass out, I think he drilled it.
We're watching a very evenly contested game Nos. Here. Neither side being able to
Fosu.
Dominate the ball.
No, I mean they've both got.
Fosu for Neymar,
players,
who's in? Neymar, yes, get in. It might even have taken a touch, you know, off Borfuck Jackson. I think it did. That's unlucky for them then. I think it was still going in, because it was the slightest of touches.
It's his responsibility. It's definitely an own goal.
Oh yeah, right off his toes. So it's unfortunate for them. But surely that's a game now for us.
To be behind now, but to do it with an own goal is particularly annoying for the team and the player in question.
Mario. Oh, fucking hell.
Good position. They've worked this attack very well.
Speculative ball then, at best start. It's easy for Leno. Now we could break again if he's on.
Could make a chance with this tackle. Well, here comes the support.
He has no strength at all as well, Ivan. That's something that needs to go up to.
He's got his tackle in. And
it's frustrating, really,
because
when you do have a young player, it does take a while this for physical stats to really go beast. That's why I love the prospect of players like Rohan.
Defender with good touches here.
He's so good. His physical's already really good.
What about Bournemouth's next game?
I was looking for
playing Spurs in the next match.
Ivan to continue his run.
I think they're going to win it easily.
Right in the bottom. He's going to switch it to him.
Now win it easily.
Via Boris.
He's better usually trusting that.
There to get rid of that.
Defender who got there first quite easily actually. And on the clock,
Boris finds Kevin. Big chance of a break here.
Attacking now.
It should be. We should get a goal here. It's Ivan through. Ivan get in. He's made to three. And, well, in the end, it is pretty comfortable. Oh, that's a celebration I haven't seen in ages. That used to be Nacho's staple. The homer we've whipped off. Ivan.
Yet again, they are a team to really admire the way they've gone about
a good finish, Ivan.
No slacking.
No, I didn't expect actually that.
Goal scoring wise and assists wise directly. He has actually had a decent season. Just sometimes he does get bullied off the ball a bit too easily for my reckon. But recent episodes he's been really good. He bailed us out against Celta Vigo when it was 0-0 quite late on.
And that's broken.
He changed
up by
the game
defender.
And the cross could come in. Grabs himself a goal here as well. I mean, he was put in trouble a bit by Christensen's driven pass, but I think his first touch should have been better there. It's allowed to put in the chance here with Gelson, but Christensen gets good. So, oh, excellent Neymar. Agility there from Ivan. Neymar held on to it, but he has won it back. I thought that was a clear foul by Borthwick Jackson, by the way. What the hell? Frustrating as well, because I was about to feed in Kevin. At least have the ball here. Can we get red? Keep our clean sheet, boys. And it's Borthwick Jackson who hoofs it over. And I think we will keep this clean sheet now. Can we add to our goals, in fact? No, it does finish 3-0. So we return to winning ways. Really important. We'd drawn three of our last five. Well, no, we'd drawn two of our last five and we'd lost one of our last five as well. Yeah, that's a City game, so it was getting a bit concerning, the form. But this is more like it. Six shots to their five, five on target to their three. Not a ruthless game. Still wasn't our best performance compared to some of them that we had from October to December, where we were absolutely lethal, like blowing teams away. But the scoreline, is the final thing, and we did win 3-0, so it was comfortable. Kevin gets him on the match, Neymar and Christensen also get ratings of above 8. As a result of this, goals for Kevin and Ivan, and one of them was an own goal, innit? Assists for Neymar and Lukaku. So two games in Manchester on the same day, really. I don't think that'll happen, FIFA.
Manchester City.
As Chelsea and Bayern come.
One. Manchester United 1, Bayern Munich 2.
Our important thing was Spurs, though. We did fail to win, so we are 4 points clear off Spurs again. Happy days. And speaking of, we do. In second, after them coming off now, Danny Mulder's this point not to start, but don't you worry about a thing, Danny. You're going to get game time now. I don't think that'll appease him. In four, it's just a silly mechanism of the game, but he still gets enough game time.
Sevilla with 34 points.
So I'm not like bowing to him, I'm just playing him in a big league game
in
like that.
Seventh, Paris Saint-Germain with 32 points.
An F for Maes, that's a shame. So I was expecting him to go up before.
Bottom of the table, Chelsea with 18
we have one more training session before the month ends, so hopefully he goes up in that session, points. Then goes up again in the monthly boost. That's why I was a bit annoyed then, but yeah, I realised he does have another one to 31st at least.
With a game in hand on the team.
Hopefully he gets an A there. It might take an A, maybe a B. A transfer offer down there. If you guys are these scouts, I'll check them out in a second. Offer for Boris. There's no way in hell I'm selling Boris. For any fee, really. It spares you on him. I'm not helping you in your title battle against us, boys, unfortunately. So, check this guy out. 75 rated, not as good as Oyaya. This guy's only 72. I thought he would have been much better, actually, looking at his stats. Shows how good our players must be. This guy, 77, is a really good one of the best new face centre backs in the game. I mean, look at him, strength 94, spin speed 86. Really similar to Timofeyev and Fornelli, actually. But, you know, again, none of them are really good enough. And I don't want to just buy players for buying players' sake. So I am going to bring this guy on the bench, the new guy I've signed, by the way. Check him out. Might be decent. I think he is Santa Cruz's regen. So expected somebody strong, but he seems different. He's a pacey player. I'm going to play Rashford, and again, Shea doesn't start. He must be wondering what he has to do to start, actually. In fact, I will start him. And I'll play Mulder there in his centre forward role, because then I can just swap Mulder out for the new guy. Ivan comes in. Munoz. So, still it's a strong team, but it's not full team. I will play Yuri, though. Ake comes in. Klosterman will play, because Martin played last game. Robinson and Timofeyev. Fuck no, I'll keep Andreas in again. I don't want to overdo it. But seeing as it is a cup game, and he had a good game in the first time round, actually, we'll bring Flavio Bustos in. Saavedra's fit again. He can come in for Neymar. De Bruyne drops out for Diaz, the new dude. I don't think I've checked Buduani out since I signed him up to the academy, actually. I really didn't need to do that. High work rate. Three star. That's decent, that. For a centre mid. Ronaldo comes in as well. Eddie. I'm aware all of these are like blue, but you know, Eddie and Ronaldo, we play midfield generally anyway. So get a couple of midfields on. Timofeyev on the bench. Bell, fucking hell, I want to sell this guy. I'm never going to play him, and he's a good prospected English player, so I need him out the door, really. Getting game time for someone else so that he improves. So it can be a tough trip, but Spurs have never actually beaten me on this save. I've won three and we drew that last one. So if that goes true to form, then at worst we will have penalties. But of course, I'm looking to try and win this in 90 minutes. Extra time wouldn't be great, to be honest, with a game against Wolfsburg coming up shortly. But there is a bit of a gap between the Wolfsburg game and the Spurs game, which is our next league match, in fact. So that'll be big, actually. The opportunity to put 7 points between us could end up being fatal for Spurs' title bid. First and foremost, let's try and knock them out of this competition. It should really have maybe checked the semi-final result in the other game. What is Eriksen doing there? I'm so glad I tackled him. That was arrogant. Trying to do a little skill pass. Mala, great cut inside there. Benteleb. Nabil, oh, he's got past. Stop him, boys, stop him. No, Eriksen. Nine, Bustos. He's so good. Continues to make save after save. Eriksen's ball in should be cleared by Tielemans, it isn't, but Bustos has it now and he can throw it to the player who's sent out, who is Ivan Rashford. Big chance here. The Shea with the pace.
Here's a chance to attack.
Looks back inside for Rash. Oh, the pass was so weak.
And that has totally
wasted
wrong.
That. I mean, first and foremost, I made the problem of doing it. Touch your head slightly wider, Shea, so it allowed Carter Vickers or Dyer to sort of catch up with
him. Obviously, it's a team game, but they're intriguing individuals.
Don't have much of a better opportunity than to get through than that. Spurs defend like they did in the first game.
Ball to be played rather than shooting themselves. They will play that ball.
What they really did well in the first game is just keep the ball. They're 57% possession. And they've kept it well there. Yeah. As they continue to get forward. Good tackle low by Robinson. Oh, I thought it was a lovely pass to first.
Switch on the attacking power in this
intercept.
Situation.
Good chance by Munoz though.
Tackle goes in. Adam.
Again, slow through ball through is just overdone by Ivan. Come on, Ivan. Passing is supposed to be a good stat, and he does seem to fire a lot of passes. And really off. Lost the man.
Rashford.
Rash. The ball to Mulder. Great tackle that though by Jan Vertonghen. Sol. Benteleb. No, no. Mario Icardi's got through. Shit. Get in, Bustos.
And that will be a goal kick.
It does show though. I'd say Spurs weren't that great last season. I beat them with ease twice. But they are a better outfit this year.
Rashford.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it.
Movement for pace. Go past there. Tongan.
Kieran Trippier.
Roofed up by Trippier to Sol.
Working hard.
Eriksen. Good little reverse pass that. Sol. They take and settle for the corner.
Will be a corner.
Again, we're going to stick a man forward. It's going to be Ivan this time. Can Yuri feed him in? Yes, he can. Chance. Oh my god. They keep coming out of nowhere, they're fucking players. Must be playing a really high line defensively. It's risky for Spurs. Credit to them, they do seem to be going for this game.
In quickly.
Here's where we can make them pay, though. And yours. Come on. Tottenham keep getting get tackles.
Looking for an opening with some
get rid of that. No! Oh, Sal wins it off the post. We're getting fortunate again, boys. Come on. Now we are playing a slightly weakened team, but it's not bad a team. Should be playing better than this.
It's Eric Dier. Promising build up.
A boil a bit performance this episode. That's a great ball, though. Shea is through now. Got to be. Adams. Yes! That's all it takes. I did say it's a dangerous game against Bournemouth, particularly with the this strike force, the quickest one in world football. I'm going to pass this off as a masterstroke, boys. I knew Spurs would play this highlight. That's why I'm playing Adams and Rashford together. Yeah, if only. But really, it's poor on Spurs' behalf tactically to place Jahai defensive line if you know you're against them. It was working when they were. You know, credit to them. They've actually played better this half.
Any football fan will say when the rain comes behind, down like it's coming down now, it's going to add to the attack, thrills. A few spills possibly.
Well, it normally does.
The gamble that they could not concede the first goal. Because now I'm just going to break through. A few more chances in the box. Offside.
We could be in.
Offside. Yeah, yeah, as they commit men forward, all I really need to do is get them on the counter. He's done well with his chance. Now header, William Robinson, and there we go. We could cancel them straight away here. Adams. Oh, he's just done him with his first touch there. Now. Cuts back inside. Looks to chip one across. Can he keep that in? I think Ivan might.
Cross coming in now.
Yes, he's won his corner. Well done, Ivan. Cleared in the end by Eric Dier. Corner whipped in by Tielemans. Straight to Lloris, but he did fuck it up a bit. I mean, he could have caught that easily. Tielemans goes a bit short this time. Aiming towards Klosterman. Jesus. Cleared in the end. It was actually looking to use Ivan for that. Here is Ivan, by the way. He looks to whip a ball in. It's definitely offside, though, by Shea Adams, our goal scorer.
He's caught offside. Maybe he made his run a bit too soon. Just failed to look across the line.
I don't get that, by the way. I know it says on the bottom that you have. It's broadcasting. I've mentioned this bot. Oh, no. There could be an here. Safe Bustos. It says the broadcasting thing.
Tottenham with the possession, but not with the lead. That's what's worrying.
I don't get why it's sort of not possible to get rid of that. It does obscure the ball sometimes.
Probing away, trying to find
Trippier. Oh, it's a great ball inside that. Shit. Oh, fucking hell. Mario Cardi's equalised. I mean, there are no away goals in this cup semi-final as well. So, yeah, unfortunately. It's not counting that we have an away goal and they don't, but it switched off for a second then. They get back in. Spurs dominated half, to be fair, they didn't deserve it. We just need to keep hold of the ball a bit more, but good thing is we have much better players on the bench.
Half starts now.
I think one or two players surprised us actually how well they played in that first half. I'd be delighted.
Eric passes it back to Tongan. Let's keep pressing them back, boys. They found their way out. They're playing a really expansive wide game, actually, Spurs, and it's working for them right now. This is their first team, though. So, it's time to stick some of our power players on. Who have we got? Oh, jeez. Our bench isn't as good as I thought it was, actually. I'll bring Rom on, though. Drop Adams back. We'll give this new guy a start, see what he's about. I'll just play Adams there. Why the fuck not? And Timofeyev comes in for Andreas, who is a bit jaded. So it's a weaker centre-back partnership, though, and taking a bit of a risk here. But Timofeyev's fast.
Some players limbering up for the away team.
Oh, lucky Jay. I thought he was on that shit. wasn't it? Cardi, Ericsson. Lovely little back heel. Ah, good footballers by Spurs. Benteleb. No, they tried one too many, you fancy bastard. You know, back heel. Twice in the build up against me.
What on EA Sports, very
wasn't the best ball through though there by Shea. Looking for Rashford. He's quick, but he's not that quick.
Away from home.
Yeah, really looking forward to this
Shea
one.
Adams chases this down. It was Shea on the end of that actually. Beg your pardon. The ball through was from the new guy Ruiz. On his debut. Ah, it's unlucky cross. Nearly got ahead there, but Seattle. Can we win this header though?
Christian Eriksen.
Should have done. Eriksen's not the tallest.
Eriksen.
Eriksen.
Eric Lamella.
Dyer.
They spread it out wide.
And he rose, so that's a good baller. Well dealt with by Ake. Team Affair gets rid. Now we could break.
Comes in
with done Fury's touch, wasn't that a rapist? But here we go, we get it back again. Fury. Rash. And we get it back. Oh, oh fuck. Just about to feed Yuri.
Half an hour to go. Here's Saul. Well,
nice they're in a good position Saul. Here. Gets his pass back out. Team Affair will cross. Go on, Mackay. Hold on. Boys, get rid of it.
Came in with the challenge and
Sergio
the
Diaz gets a tackle. Well, in that. New dude. Shea has pace. If he can get past this dude, he's back Carter Vickers. Fucking hell, Danny Rose is no slouch, so is he, let's face it. He did cut across. Right now, it does look like we may well end up heading towards extra time. Big tackle, that.
Yeah, he's dominating things, isn't he? He's really down there, demanding the
big
ball.
Big tackle by Spurs, though. Carter Vickers now, here comes Eric Lamella. Eriksen. There's a ball on through there, and he found it. Shit. Tango Correa, he's a good finisher. Oh, he does put it wide. We've kept them quiet this half, Spurs. We've only had one chance.
But he just couldn't finish it.
What a chance to have, Team of Five. Yeah, against Fans Munoz. Big tackle again.
Foul against Spurs.
And fair one. I actually disagree. I thought they would have bowled it. I'm willing to admit that for having put up a good challenge, and that was what we did. Uri Tielemans.
Good forward play from them.
They love sliding in. Trippier this time. We have a good tackle.
Throw in coming up.
It does bode well. I mean, Spurs are still failing to beat what is essentially my
Adams.
Second 11. And we play them in the league next week.
It's Eric Dyer.
But they definitely have improved. They didn't play this well against me last year at all. It's two games running now. I'm really struggling to even get the ball. Tango Correa picks it up. Looks to feed it inside. Klosterman doesn't clear it well. Oh, fuck. That's the wrong time to do that. I was tapping a shit out of wise, actually been the keeper out. Not realizing Klossman would get it.
So
clearance.
Just to remind you of the aggregate score,
straight to them. Shot off the.
Switch on the attacking situation.
Rebounds off the post and straight away. With the rebound put in. Munoz.
Adams.
How typical was that, by the way? I had no viewer when I was winning. Viewer
pass.
Tuned in and they got me back. Oh, Lukaku.
Knock it away.
Why did you miss the ball? He's been so bad recently, Lukaku. He's actually, since probably overall, Rashford is probably, to be fair. But he's one of our top scorers in the whole club. Oh, we could get a goal here, though. Adams, get in. We are back in it. Lukaku did get the assist that time, but it was all about the pass inside. And saying here, Rashford, Lukaku and Adams. Combining and a great finish by Shea. He's got a brace now. Well in, Adams. Get in.
And here we are on aggregate scores, level at 2-2.
Dyer. Eric.
Substitution for Spurs coming up.
It's Benteleb.
Could be dangerous.
Ali.
Got the tackle in.
How annoying's that, by the way? I noticed a viewer tuned in when I was like, break off here. It's a big chance to win it. Lukaku. Oh my god. That's what I'm talking about, Ron. He's on his weak foot. Should have scored that. I had time and everything.
Substitution time.
But yeah, when it was 1-0 up, a viewer tuned in. And they scored pretty much straight away. They equalised it. Then they went 2-1 up. And as soon as they went 2-1 up, he stopped watching. And I scored the second. Now they've got so whoever that for you was, you cursed, mate. I'm glad you stopped. No! Oh, and go Correa's won it last minute, boys. I don't believe it. It was a sick ball through. What a finish that was, but just after we could have won it. It's a crushing blow. Ah, Rashford gives it away. It's going to be Cairns. We get one more chance. So, Jammy deflection. Takes the ball in the air and wastes a bit more time. They did deserve it, to be fair, but maybe I paid for putting a weakened team on. So I could, yeah, I just couldn't really put any more first teamers out. We had players with fitness issues across the board. I did think we had enough in the team to get past Spurs then. Clearly wasn't the case. They do win 3-2. So I'll look to get my revenge against them next week in the league. Another game, absolute thrashing. Real Madrid beat Newcastle 5-1 now. Good. So Real, Spurs final. I will be rooting Tottenham on, probably. That's the aura of the English team.
English League Cup semi-final.
Yeah, frustrating now. I did want to win every cup, actually, but the main thing we are targeting is the treble. So we have still in the main competitions. It is the fourth priority, the League Cup, but I haven't gotten so far. I had hopes that we could do something then. As I said, still though, the more important game to come is Wolfsburg. Hopefully we fare a bit better against them. Scott, this guy is not great. I'm not even going to put him on the shortlist. Still going to hear back from Leguero. He's looked decent. Cruz Torres, showing great potential. Not going to make the cut then. There's still no great new face player. I mean, where are the next great players in the game coming from? I don't understand. It's like, you know, it's bullshit. FIFA, at this stage, you know, in world football, there's always players who's under 23, who's OP. You know, a young player who you will not have heard of 3 years ago, who's really, really amazing now. And it's just not happening in this file. Aside from Romano, Abeledo and Rice, you know, I've not seen one that's 80 rated still of these young players. So we're going to stop it. We have transfer deadline day, of course. Oh no, because you do this, maybe you don't get the chance to train on transfer deadline day. That's so annoying. I'm not sure if you can train off another screen. I'll try and find out that. Stefan Lundgren, by the way, 3 months in, still looks pretty good, so we'll sign him up. Henriksen's already gone. Arvidsson, we'll find out more about. This guy looks very good, potentially. Lindqvist. We don't know enough about him to make sure. Mats Eriksson, shit. He can go. Victor Johnson, again. Find out more about him. Same with Mats Eklund. Lindstrom, no, for me. Oh my word, though. That was the only one we got back. Have I not sent my scouts out for a full month and not realised? That's an amateur mistake. We could have spent our cash on that. No, interesting. Ah, the returning on the day. I thought they all returned just before the month's out, so fair enough. They'll be back tomorrow. So let's see if we do get final bids. I'm pretty sure I listed Sean Bell. Two elves have got listed. No one's coming for. Canase, the Saint, Bell, Brewer, Benabia, Shaw, Jujovic, and Payard. Still waiting for bids for these boys. So I'll just take the future hit of losing more cash if I just waited. And if people do come in for likes of Payard, I will just ask for like 4.5 million. Someone will get a bargain. It's their reward for coming in. What? Andre Gomez left Barcelona for nothing. Someone signed him up on a pre-contract then. He's 90 rated. What a miss for Barca that is. You know, I'm not sort of ruined now. We're not doing any pre-contracts for the rest of the series, so that wasn't a possibility. But we could have got a monster player there if we'd wanted to. It looks like a quiet deadline day so far. Laporte went to City though for 58 mil. So City doing what they usually do when they go and get stuff and just splashing the cash. They're in danger of getting relegated right now. They did beat us though, to be fair, so that helped out their cause. We do have a transfer offer for the Saints. This is Robin's regen and we only got in August, so I'm surprised it's letting us sell him. Porto want him. I'm going to ask for 5.5 mil, which I think is fair. No, 3.6 valuation, 1972 already. If they turn around and say we don't think he's worth that much, then just fuck off, Porto, because I've offered you a great deal here for Robin's regen as well. 4.3. I'm going to have to accept it, because... Let me say that. Do I have to? I do have a lot of cash still left. I have about 3 or 4 spots free in my squad, I think. I think I sold a couple of players this window. I did bring one in now. I think I have 3 spots available. And I can't see too many more youth players leaving before then, so... Yeah, might as well just keep all of them. It's their own fault, Porto. I gave them a fair offer there, 5.5. More for you. Could still loan someone out now, if we do get a bid. To be fair, forgot about that. We do have message. Oh, this might be worth it as well, yeah. Isaac Davis goes on loan to Erebro SK, whoever they are. So, see you later, Isaac. Maybe that takes him up a rating or two. Advance now, do a squad monthly report and all that jazz, then we'll call it a day for this episode. Not a great episode in the hole, actually, then. Thinking about it, I mean, you've got lost in that League Cup thing. I didn't lose for ages, and I've lost 2 out of 3 now. 2-1 to City, 3-2 against Spurs, although, as I said, to be fair against Spurs, we had a weakened team up. But we did beat Sporting 3-0 away, so we did actually extend our lead in the league this episode. Believe it or not, I think Spurs drew both, or drew one and lost one, something like that. But yeah, that defeat was disappointing. However, we do await Wolfsburg next episode, then the Spurs game, where we hopefully we get revenge as we travel to the lane again. Full strength on that one, for sure. And PSG at home. It's a really quiet month, February. No, in fact, I might even play every game in this episode. It just depends. No, alright, I won't, because ideally we're going to beat Wolfsburg and then the next FA Cup game will fall then, I think. The Arsenal game will get moved. It may get moved to there, in fact, the Arsenal game. March looks fucking busy right now. A bit less so April and May. Just depends on how far we get in competitions, of course. Your squad monthly report, we will check that after we've gone to these Scotland updates, of course. Lewis Cook is in note. We had the Lewis Cook, in fact, in our team, who we offered to City to get in Kevin De Bruyne. He's good, Lewis Cook. This guy's already gone. That's a shame, because he could have been really good, Owen Lewis. We'll hear more about Harvey Allen. Pete Wilson. But yeah, Lewis Cook was 82 rated. He was a good player. That guy was as good, I might have considered. This guy's potential looks really good, but his overall really poor, so I don't know what to believe there. No to Brandon Wilson. Jordan Robertson looks like he could be decent. But again, all these decent looking guys are like a month in. So I don't know enough about them. We'll find out more. And last one is New Zealand, where this guy looks decent. Billy Price, CM. I do need to make space, so I'll do that at the end. Ethan Hughes, another one. His overall looks really low though, so again, I'll find out a bit more about him. No to Dylan Kelly, no to Bradley Brown. Wow, look at Oliver Bell, by the way. 54 to 68, 80 to 94. Now this guy I will sign up straight away. I'll make space for him, because I was about to say actually when I got to the end, until I saw him. Billy Price, I might as well just find out more about, because there's no one really I want to get rid of right now from the academy. No one that stands out, anyway. I'll review it, obviously, for further months update. Some players might have gone down. I can definitely get rid of some of these guys from the respective academy, but yeah, Oliver Bell will arrive. Two makes way. So here's the update. Magnus Petersen still looks amazing. 89-94. It's the only one we've taken from Sweden so far, I think, but he's really good. Jay Cox has gone up in rating, I think. 49 overall. It's pretty low, but his potential is good, and he is English. Lewis still looks very good. Toby Hughes, we just signed up, I think. I'll let him go, I think. Hen Clark still looks okay. Aiden Price, very good. 16 and 61. 70-86 though. What the hell? Surely he'll get higher than that, I think. Hugh Morris is decent as well. Van der Velde, we do have another Belgian. He looks good as well, this guy. So he's only 15. Florian Janssens, another Belgian, but he's only 45 overall, so I think I might get rid of him too. Don Baker looks decent. Again, the potential could be as low as 68. Obviously, that's not going to be the case. I'm still waiting on that to get updated. Elliot Morris, Charles Robinson. The problem is that, unlike previous times, a lot of these guys in the academy right now do have sick potential, but they have really low overalls, some of them. Likes of Robinson and Max Hall there. Stefan Lundgren is looking good. I'm signing this guy up. I must have just signed him or something. Tim Roth, we know all about. He's a Oscar feature star, an absolute monster player from the looks of it. Gabriel Xavier, 66 there. So we can sign this Kiwi up now, Oliver Bell. And we've found out more about these boys. So straight back to here to check out Bell. So where's he at? There he is, 57 overall, decent, 80-94. Not as good as Pettersson, or Peterson, whatever his name is, or Tim Roth. But, so looks good. I'm aware, by the way, I know it's not called previous episodes, so his name is Tom Roth, but we call him Tim Roth after the English actor, because it's so like it. Another German. I'm not going to offer him his contract just yet, but very soon we're going to have to offer Xavier's contract. He's 18 now, in fact, we'll do it now, just before he does fuck off. Credit to him, actually, for sticking around this long. I've had people just leave when they're 16, like little bitches, but Gabriel's been patient. Waiting for his opportunity, he's about to be rewarded. So last thing to do before we do hop off this episode is check the update. So no go for Leno, he's staying where he's at until he gets 30 at least. Klossmann's still 84. Hernandez still 84. Andreas still yet to grow actually, but yes, Boris has gone up to 81 now. Now he's as good as Ake officially. Excellent from Boris. His sprint speed just keeps going up as well. I thought he was quicker than actually. He seems it. In the game. Maybe just because his marking's so good and he's generally well positioned. But stamina's really good as well, so you know. Ake is going to see less and less game time. May end up selling Ake. And utilising the other left back I have. That'll be a few seasons down the road though. You know, when Boris gets to be like an absolute monster player. Because he will hit at least 85, as we've seen. And, I think, look at that, 81, 21. Boris will end up like 89, 88, surely. Timothy, 82 still. Halilovic didn't grow either, still 89. Same with Fiori, 88. No go for Kevin, he's reached his max, but what an impact he's had. Look at that, 7 goals, 8 assists in the Premier League. Been excellent. 10 and 8 for Neymar, he's also been very good. Rom 6-3, but most of them goals were when he first came back. As I said, he's stumbled in recent weeks. Rom, Ivan's going away, get in, 86 now. It's a bit annoying actually, because I was training him then, so it sort of resets the training, but I can't complain when he's growing up. Kind of him right in there, I suppose. 7 goals, 4 assists, in the FA Cup particularly, he was amazing in that game, 9.4. So the stats have gone up. His stamina's really good now as well. Acceleration, sprint speed. But his main passing is his passing. His main stats, sorry, his passing is dribbling. His ball control, his finishing's really good as well for right mid. Rash, 88 rated still. It's been pretty good this season. Played 20 games, which is decent enough. Shea Adams, 32. No growth at all for Ake. That's just throwing me off completely. I don't understand that. You know, it seems he's just reached his potential, which is like bullshit. He's 25. He should be growing. Mignon's 80 rated. Jay Robinson's still 78. Danny Mulder's growing again. Get him. He's such a beast. 16 games, 7 goals, 7 assists. You know, he got an assist in that FA Cup game I played him in as well. 81 rated now, 21. He's matched Boris and he's not played anywhere near as much. Danny Mulder is the real deal. I'm starting to prefer him over Shea Adams, to be honest, when we bring him on. He might well become the fourth choice striker, just behind, of course, Lukaku, Rash and Neymar. The Saint, still 72. I'd hoped he'd maybe grown then, after he decided to keep him, but you know, by next window, we'll probably be like a 74. We can sell him for like 6-7 mil then, maybe. Timofeev, still a 75. Eddie's still an 80 rated, but I'm sure some of them stats have gone up further. His finishing's 92, which is amazing. Edwin's still 73. Lance Hughes, I think crew rating actually, 67 now. It's a shame we didn't manage to sell Bell, because his contract's going to run out, so I'll just let that happen. Manny, 79 rating still. Pierre Payard's growing a rating. 74 now. It's all the better, because next window when we do sell him, again, we get even more. Dietrich, 77 still. Saavedra, still 73. Dietrich needs to play more, man. I've only played him 9 times, just realised. Compare that to some of the other guys that he's similar to. Won't be as much as like Siv Cruz, I think. Sam Martin, still 77. Esteban, still an 80 rating. Canate, Cruz, all the same. To be fair, Cruz only played 2 more times than Dietrich, so more of a balance. But Dietrich has potential to be special. Cruz doesn't, so need to get redressed on, not for him more. Another player has potential to be special, one of many in our subs and reserves right now, Bustos, is still at an 80. Myers did make it to a 67, so it's a shame we couldn't trade him on that day. It was so annoying that, in fact. But yeah, has potential to be special, but he will continue to fly up. Sean Shaw's gone up 7 times. He's only played 1 game, by the way. We did train him for a bit, but it's insane. He's probably only gone up about 2 by our training. Maybe 3. Jujovic, still 70. Bernabia went up in rating. This guy's flying up, to be fair, considering we barely play him as well. Buduani started to grow. Ah, we did indeed check him. He's an exciting prospect. So he had the tag of 86 to 92, so he'll be at least 86 rated. Max peak. Declan Shaw, transfer listed. Still a 70. It's a shame we didn't get rid of him. He's an English high potential keeper. You know, he has potential to be special as well, this guy. But he's not going to get game time for the rest of the season, though. Sergio Diaz started to go up already. Lovely stuff. Oh god, Ronaldo's gone down in rating. Again. 81 now. 80 rated, sorry, now. From 81. Oh, by the way, he scored in every competition except the Premier League. Right, that's my goal. I'm going to try and get him a Premier League game goal before the end of the season. Aiden Alexander on loan out there. Yaya on loan. None of these will grow till May, I think, or June, which is the second loan update. And Rohan, still gone. I think it was a year-long loan, so he must have done this in August. I just must not remember. So, yeah, we won't get him back till next window now. Same with Aresti. In fact, I think Aresti's on a 2-year loan now. So let's just double check before we do call it a day. Wow, I mean, we didn't actually increase that much because Buduani arrived off seat. We've just offered Xavier a spot. We'll still only have one spot free in the squad. This is the endless battle these days, just trimming a squad down, getting rid of players, whilst not being ripped off in the process. But if you look at the age of this team, it's just insane. I'll go from top to bottom then. The oldest player in our squad will be Ronaldo, of course, 35. But then, we only have one player over 30. So only one player decreasing in stats right now, which is so good. And when Ronaldo goes, that'll free a huge chunk of the wage budget as well. He's still worth 18 mil, by the way, Ronaldo. Measure how quality he is. Yep, there we go. So De Bruyne, 29, a couple of 28-year-olds, a couple of players here. Sort of near in the mid-20s, but the vast majority of players in this side, you can see, are teenagers from this point downward. Yeah, look at Abeledo, by the way, 86 rated, he's only on £705 a week. He doesn't complain. He made it further than David Romano. In fact, David was 20 when he left as well. He was 83 rated, I think, David, so Ivan's actually better than that age. I do need to remember his age sometimes, Ivan. He will come on. This was about the time David upped his game, big time. All these 18-year-olds as well. You know, the likes of Eddie, 80 rated. Fucking hell. Cruz, 77. So no 16-year-olds on the side, actually. Some of them have gone up in age since, I think. But oh, so many good prospects now. You look at the overall, our lowest rated player, in fact, is Davis. Take Davis, Shaw, Moore, Konate out, who are not on the plans long term. Buduani probably isn't in long term plans either. Nevis Bell or Benavia. From Mace upwards, you know, all of these guys are players that would have been in my 18 probably from the start of the game. I would have been pushing it, and then from about Diaz onwards, they'd have been my first team. So fucking young, so good, the potential of this team. That is it for this episode, guys. Only one more thing left for me to do. In fact, no, I was going to check the FA Cup fixture to see who everyone else got, but I think I did look at it. So yeah, just quick glance and next episode. Already done that as well, haven't I? Right, I'm rambling, I'm wasting time, so we'll just call it a day there. Thanks for joining me for this episode, guys, and I hope to see you again.